In this chapter, you will place zones in the rooms and create dimensioned model views, which can be part of the documentation. You may continue working on the current project, or open the TS03 Chapter 3 PLN ARCHICAD solo project file to complete this chapter of the training series. Zones represent rooms in the building. They are defined by categories in the attributes section of the program. ARCHICAD zones are real 3D spaces. You can use them to create conceptual space studies, as well as to create detailed space lists and area calculations. You can trim the 3D zone spaces to slabs, roofs, or beams to create more accurate volume calculations. Use the options, Project Preferences, Zones command to fine-tune the zone-related calculations and element subtractions. We'll use the defaults now. Zones can gather information from the surrounding building elements, like door and window openings or roof trims. Zones can identify existing geometry as boundaries, walls, lines, polylines, columns, etc. Later on, you can update zones so they follow the changes of the boundary geometry. Based on how you want to use zones, automatic boundaries can be the reference lines or the contour lines of walls. Later, you can edit the edges of the zone with the polyline editing methods or edit the zone body with solid element operations. If there are no defined boundary lines, or if you use zones before modeling the building itself, like in an early design phase, you can set the boundary lines manually with polyline editing methods. Open the ground floor in the project map of the pop-up navigator or simply from the tab bar. Activate the zone tool in the toolbox and open its settings dialog. Display the name and positioning page. Select Education and Culture for category. Enter exhibition space for name. Set the zone top to gallery. Enter 0.24 for top offset to top linked story. This is the thickness of the slab above. Select ground floor for home story. Enter 0.00 for bottom elevation to project 0. Select the inner edge geometry method. Display the settings page. Turn off or uncheck scale sensitivity. Choose finishes and heights. Turn on floor finish. Select parquet for the finish. Open area and volume. Also, turn on measured area, as well as ceiling height. Open appearance, and select none for the frame style. Make sure that the model unit zone layer is selected. Click OK to apply all changes and close the dialog. The zone is set to automatic boundary detection using the inner edge geometry method. This means that the zone boundaries will be found automatically along the inner edges of the elements. Click inside the large room area to detect the boundary. Note that the cursor changes to a hammer. Click again to place the zone stamp. The point you clicked is marked with a small blue plus sign. This represents the point around which the zone boundary detection recognizes the zone area. This means that if you draw a new boundary element between the stamp and the plus sign, the zone will be updated based on the plus sign. Let's add some additional zones. Open the Zone Settings dialog and display the Name and Positioning page. Select Communication and Access for category. Enter Entrance for name. Enter -0.46 for top offset to top linked story. This is the thickness of the terrace slab above the entrance. Display the settings page. Select parquet for the floor finish under finishes, heights, Click OK to close the dialog. Place this zone to the entrance area. Enter WC in the name field in the info box. Notice that zone numbers increase automatically when you place a new zone. Select Technical Equipment for category in the info box. Place this zone to the water closet area. Enter washroom into the name field in the info box. Place this zone to the room as presented on the screen. Please note that you can change the boundary of the automatic zones with polyline editing methods, but they keep their automatic behavior. This means that if you run the Design, Update Zones command, these automatic zones will recalculate their area based on the boundary geometry around their plus signs. Let's add another zone on the gallery level. Open Gallery from the pop-up navigator or simply from the tab bar. Open the Zone Settings dialog and display the Name and Positioning page. Select Education and Culture for category. Type Gallery for name. Select Roof for zone top. And set the top offset to top linked story to 0.00. Display the settings page. Select Parquet for the floor finish under Finishes, Heights. Click OK. Place the zone as before by clicking into the gallery area. We can see that the zone extends beyond the gallery slab and fills the opening of the stairs as well. Let's fix this. Select the zone, change to the manual construction method, and click its bottom edge to display the pet palette. Select the Offset Edge command on the pet palette. Offset the edge to the edge of the gallery slab. Now with the zone still selected, click its edge again to display the pet palette. Select the Subtract from Polygon command this time. Hold down the Space key and notice that the shape of the cursor changes to a magic wand. Click the edge of the stairs with the magic wand to subtract its area from the zone. Deselect the zone.